Our Story Productions presents the Cocklebur Morning Show, where we weed out the big stories from throughout Sweet Swan County with Bobby Ray and Sally Sue.
Oh, thank you, thank you, and welcome to our show today. And what a fantastic show we have.
Yes, we do.
And we have to welcome you back.
Thank you, Sally Sue.
Oh,
I appreciate that very much.
We missed you so much.
Yep.
Where were you for 2 whole weeks? No explanation. You just made that call.
Well, the situation was this, Sally Sue.
Okay.
I have become, let's just say, really good friends with Clarice Plow from Hidden Away, Not Forgotten.
Clarice Plow. Mm-hmm. Didn't she write that book?
Oh, yeah.
About the women of Sweet Swan County?
Yeah, it's entitled Not So Sweet, a real page-turner, let me tell you.
It's kind of a tell-all.
Anyway, Clarice... Oh, yeah, kind of.
Yeah.
Anyway, Clarice asked if I would help with the book tour.
Oh, really?
Yes. So I tagged along, and I thought I could pick up some historical sites along the way as well. And also, be able to find out some more about those people that we could use against. I mean, just some more research.
Yeah, research is always good. But Bobby Ray, honestly, 2 weeks? 2 whole weeks?
Well, I thought that I'd be back by showtime. But, to get that kind of information, I had to wine and I had to dine. I spent my entire expense account on Clarice.
Your whole expense?
The whole thing. I spent every dime. I spent so much money, I had to walk back to Sweet Swan County. I did hitchhike.
Well, you must have done something really good because we got something. I have a note.
What'd we get?
We got a present. It says Bobby Ray and Sally Sue. Just a little present for promoting the book Clarice wrote. Love the women of Sweet Swan County. And I'm sure the hugs and kisses are for you.
Okay.
But
what'd we get?
Close your eyes.
Okay.
What do you think?
Oh.
I'm thinking the note is sweeter than the gift.
They must be confused.
I'm
Those
thinking.
Poor girls, it's not the Cocklebur morning show.
No,
it's the Cocklebur morning show. But they're a little bit behind the curve.
And
the elevator doesn't go to the top floor, but that's okay.
And if you read the book,
let me tell you,
issues.
And I got some scoop after spending all that money on Clarice.
Mm-hmm.
I'll talk to you later.
Oh, okay. I can't wait.
Okay. But anyway, why don't we join another one of our citizens outside of Sweet Swan County?
Oh, wonderful.
Okay.
Oh, hello again. Colonel Von Breger here. I was just going over some of my adventures here in my journal. Have I ever told you about the time I was on safari in Africa? Perhaps not. Or the time I flew over uncharted waters in the Black Sea. There again, perhaps I haven't shared that with you. Well, these are some of my adventures, and I'm going to be doing other adventures now in the South, specifically southern Minnesota, visiting towns and communities. In fact, we're taking an adventure today. Why don't you join me as we go to...
Gaylord, Minnesota is located 60 miles southwest of the Twin Cities metropolitan area and is home to the Sibley County Courthouse and other historical buildings. This thriving community is comprised of education, healthcare, recreational amenities, agriculture, business, and industry. Gaylord is successful because people come together with a desire to promote this as the best community for families, seniors, businesses, and taxpayers.
Bully. Well, let's discover some of the fine businesses and establishments as we continue our adventure.
Thank you.
Wasn't that a great town?
Yes, it was. Absolutely.
Wow. Now, I'm sure that you have a fabulous weekend, or should I say 2 weekends
like
to tell
I
us
said,
about.
I told you a story, and I'm sticking to it.
Research,
however,
research,
I did find, let me find my notes here. I did find lots of interesting places, historical places, on my two-week adventure. I'll be sharing them over the next couple of shows, but for tonight, what I'd like to do is, oh, wait a minute, we've got to say it. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, get ready for
Bobby Ray's Weekend Adventures.
Isn't that good?
Oh, that's wonderful, yeah.
All right.
I'm so thrilled.
So, thank you. So was I. So was Clarice.
Anyway, sure was.
The Sibley County Courthouse in Gaylord, Minnesota.
Oh, Gaylord,
yes, was completed in 1917 at a cost of $128,786.
Wow.
That's
that's expensive.
But you know, today, that'd be a lot of money.
Yeah.
It was a lot of money back,
back then,
too. Right, but I mean, today that would be like $1 million or $2 million
or
$3 million.
Yes, definitely. Wow.
The combination Mission Spanish Revival and Classical Revival style building features six two-story columns, a classic pediment, bronze entry doors, and a stained glass skylight in the dome above the three-story octagonal rotunda.
Oh,
I mean, it's beautiful.
I bet it's wonderful.
It's really, it's beautiful. It's just a work of art.
My.
Inside the main office floor is marble-faced. The ceiling is coffered and enameled and decorated with colored marble at the top of the walls. Two marble stairways rise to the second level.
Oh, wow. Beautiful.
I thought our courthouse in Sweet Swain County was nice.
Yeah. Oh,
and it is, but this is like,
Beautiful.
I'm telling you, it's great. It was really great. I loved it. You know, and after I got done looking at the courthouse and visiting there, I jumped in the car with Clarice, and I drove over to... the Steele County, Owatonna.
Oh, yes.
Great town.
Yes.
Great town. And I went over there and visited the historic Steele County Courthouse.
Okay.
And that was built in 1891 for $50,000.
Wow.
Yep, in Owatonna, Minnesota. It's been remodeled several times and is used solely by the courts now. There's no county court or nothing like that in there. The Steele County Courthouse is a three-story Austin red brick building.
It's
it's beautiful.
Oh, that is.
With red mortar.
Ooh.
Accented with Lake Superior brown stone.
Ooh.
Oh, yes.
That must
It was designed by T.D. Allen of Minneapolis in Romanesque, Revival, and Italianate style. I don't know if I said that quite right.
Oh, you did really well.
It features corner towers, a turret, and a large clock on four sides.
My.
And it works.
And the clock works.
Yep.
Wow.
Windows are arched, and a statue representing mercy, law, and justice sits above the north face of the building. Polished granite columns support double arches at the entrances. The interior is decorated with wainscoting, woodwork, and an ornate oak staircase. I mean, it's just
fabulous.
It's like the Taj Mahal of county courthouses. It's really top shelf.
Well appointed.
Oh, absolutely. The Steele County Courthouse was added to the National Register of Historical Places in 1987. So it's a pretty special place.
Yes, definitely.
I would recommend our viewers take the time, travel to both of these. It'll be well worth their time.
Wonderful, wonderful.
Yep. Well, there you have it. Another segment of
Bobby Ray's Weekend Adventures.
Wonderful, wonderful. Well, that was great. Now, what do you say we visit another town outside of Sweet Swain County?
Yeah, I think that's a great idea.
Yeah.
Let's do that.
Hello, my name is Lady Dot, and I'm from Spottingham, England, and I've traveled the entire world with my dog, Spot. After all, how could I not call my dog Spot? But I digress. I wanted to tell you about some of the exciting communities I've found here in southern Minnesota. So if you would like to join me, please pull up a chair and I will pour you a spot of tea. One moment, please. Gertrude, we need a teacup. This is the creamer. Thank you. My apology. As I was saying, please pull up a chair and we will explore some of these exciting communities together.
Called the Four Season Funland, scenic Lake Benton is small but beautiful. For recreation, Lake Benton Lake is the sixth largest lake in southern Minnesota, and the hole in the mountain prairie and 1,100-acre wildlife preserve is owned by the Nature Conservancy. From the past, the 1896 Opera House is listed on the National Register of Historic Places, while today, more than 600 wind turbines grace the skyline along the Buffalo Ridge. With great schools and a library and museums and civic organizations, Lake Benton is a great place to visit or to live and work.
Did I not tell you that that community is spot on? Why don't we have a look at a few of their businesses?
How they continue to do it. But the citizens of Sweet Swine County find all these fantastic towns.
I know. It's amazing.
Yes.
You know, and I'm sure we'll see more during the show.
Oh, yes.
Right now,
I can't wait.
Right now, why don't we invite our guest out today?
Yes.
I'm telling you, I'm excited about this.
I am too. Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, our guest today is well-known on national TV, has been on various talk shows. We are so pleased and proud to have with us today Martin County's own Tron guy, Jay Maynard.
Oh,
welcome,
yes,
Jay. Welcome.
Hi.
Welcome.
Welcome, Jay, to our show. It's a delight to have you here.
I'm happy to be here.
Jay, it is a pleasure to have you here, but I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
Where in the heck did you get that suit?
I had it custom made.
Really?
The characters in the movie Tron, if you look, their bodies are all green. And the other folks who made costumes like this, they tended to make them out of white. And I felt that was kind of wimping out on it.
Mm-hmm.
So I actually went to Fleet and picked this color of paint and painted up the identity disc here.
Identity disc.
And sent it off to a lady who I dealt with before and had her make the unitard custom to my size and match the color.
That is very unique.
So what did you use? I mean, there's soft
this
pieces,
is,
hard
yes.
pieces. What did you
mm-hmm.
use to make
The soft pieces are all cotton spandex.
Okay.
It's actually one piece covers the entire body.
Oh, really?
This is the same kind of hockey helmet that they actually used in the movie.
Hmm. That's an actual
Cooper hockey helmet.
Wow, and you have all the wires?
Identity disc.
That's the identity disc.
Genuine.
Look at that.
Genuine
wow.
whammo. This is formed PVC, and that's a football shoulder guard.
Really? Wow.
Wow, I'm,
wow
you know,
amazing.
And I understand, because I've watched a couple of your national broadcast
yes.
programs.
Impressive.
Oh, very much so.
Yes.
And I want to know how the web helped you. But before you answer that, I think I'd like to give our viewers a treat. And let's see what Tron Guy looks like. Lit up, lights off. Louie,
oh.
hit the lights.
Oh, wow.
That was cool.
I loved it. Wow.
So now, as I was asking you now, how did the web help this all take off for you?
Without the web, it wouldn't have happened at all.
Okay.
As I was making the costume, I was getting help from a lady in New York City.
Really?
So getting from here to New York City is not something you just jump in your car and drive across town
no.
to do. So I took pictures as I was going along and put them together for a web page for her so she could see the progress and give me hints. When it was done, I said, okay, fine, maybe other folks would like to make a costume like this. So I put the page up on the web for everybody to look at. And it became one of those pages that everybody emailed all their friends, hey, you got to go check out this web page. And so without the web, it wouldn't have happened at all.
That's amazing. Now, in part of what I watched You were at a convention, a computer convention, an electronics convention. Why don't you explain that to us?
It's actually a combination science fiction and computing convention.
Okay.
It turns out that the kind of people who go to either of those, there's a lot of overlap. Ooh. Somebody notices, hey, let's make one that does both. And that was the first science fiction convention I'd ever been to. So I went to that, saw a masquerade, thought, hey, you know, it'd be interesting to try to make a costume. And being a combination science fiction and computer convention, I thought Tron, being a science fiction movie mm-hmm. about computing, would
sure.
be a subject to draw from.
Well, that's interesting. Brilliant.
Interesting. Wonderful. So when you're not Tron Guy, what do you do in the real world?
How do you know he doesn't do anything else except Tron Guy?
No. I wish I could make a living off of this, but no. Big surprise, I'm a computer consultant.
Oh, I'm shocked.
Yeah, I do computers for a living.
That makes sense.
Neat. That makes sense.
So did you dress up a lot when you were a little kid?
No, not really.
Really?
I really didn't do anything in the way of costuming, with one exception, until this happened. The one exception being Renaissance fairs. I'd go to those in Garden.
Yeah.
In fact, the lady I bought the unitard from was the lady who I bought my tights for my Renaissance clothing from.
I understand. Oh, now, that lady that you bought your unitard from, is she from New York? Is that the lady you're speaking of?
No, okay. She was in Indiana.
Really?
And that's where she was.
So
the lady in New York is a good friend who I'd met sometime before, and she helped me with things like paint and you know, the techniques of doing it.
Gave you some technical ideas.
Now,
when you were at that convention, I'll bet you got a lot of looks, didn't you?
Well, I did. I kept it very closely under wraps until the time of the contest. It was a masquerade costume contest. And the reason I did that is that one of the judges of that contest was a friend.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
So I wanted to avoid trading on that friendship. Mm-hmm. So I kept it very closely held until it came time for everybody to get together to have the costumes inspected before the actual presentation. And I was standing around in the hall just outside the room where we were meeting, and it turns out that she was the first one to walk up and see me. And she took one look at me and said, wow. And that was the reaction pretty much the entire weekend.
Awesome.
That's great. How many people were there approximately?
About 500.
Wow.
And when I made the costume, I expected maybe 500 people would ever see it. Boy, was I wrong.
Going around the world how many times?
It's gone well beyond anything that I had ever imagined.
So what other TV shows have you appeared on? I mentioned a couple of national ones. I was just curious.
I was on Jimmy Kimmel Live a bunch the year that this happened.
Really?
Year was that, Jay?
That was 2004. So it's five and a half years ago now.
Okay.
It seems like a lifetime. But I've also been parody on South Park, and I had no idea that was coming. They didn't ask me. They didn't tell me. The first I knew about it was when this same lady in New York sends me an instant message on the computer, says, "Turn on Comedy Central now," and we did, and there I was. My only complaint about that segment is that they got the voice wrong. I mean, listen to me. Do I sound like I'm from Minnesota?
Yes.
Say something with an O in it.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Minnesota.
Yeah, there you go. Pretty much.
I'm from Houston originally.
You've got a little southern twang. I thought I heard that. Okay.
And so they made me sound like I was from Minnesota, don't you know?
Oh, they get the, you betcha, yeah, sure. Eh?
Not quite, but it made it, you could hear it in there.
Okay.
So the voice was wrong. Other than that, you know, it wasn't bad.
That's great.
And I've been on Tech TV G4 a few times, and most recently on Tosh.0 on Comedy Central.
Oh, really?
That was just a month ago.
That's great. And what was on what program on Comedy Central?
It was Tosh.0.
Tosh.0. Okay. I've not watched that one yet.
I haven't either. No. So now, with all this national acclaim, that certainly has changed your life a little bit. How has that?
I refer to it as when my life got turned upside down.
Really?
The convention was the weekend of tax day 2004.
Oh.
And in the run-up to that, I'm just your average computer consultant and toiling anonymously in Fairmont. And then the next week, it seemed like every radio station was calling me asking for an interview, and I did a lot of those. The folks from Kimmel called, and it's for a guy who's never had any of that kind of exposure, it's really something to get off of an airplane and suddenly turn into somebody important. They had, chauffeured limo at the airport, put me up in a nice hotel just down the street from the studio, the whole nine yards.
That's great.
That's wonderful.
That had to be. And now you've been there how many times?
The total is now 16.
Wow. I'm impressed.
Yes.
And I had a lot of fun doing that.
I can imagine.
Wow, that's amazing. Mm-hmm. Right in Fairmont, Martin County?
Right next door.
In Sweet Swain County, yes. Yeah. Amazing.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So, Jay, what are your future plans for Tron Guy?
Generally, what I've found is that people that promote themselves on the Internet get shot down in flames. The Internet is probably the best detector there is of, let's say, pig exhaust.
I know what you mean.
Yes. So,
good.
I'll take it as it comes.
Well, I'll tell you what. I just have one favor before we have you leave.
Mm-hmm.
Do us both a favor and do not appear on the show Women of Sweet Swain County.
You cannot go there.
We really worked hard to get you here, so we prefer that you not be on the Women of Sweet Swain.
Okay, competition.
Yes,
yeah.
Kind of, just a little.
Just a little.
Okay.
Friendly competition.
Friendly,
yes.
Okay?
Love them all.
And if you'll do that, then we'll give you another city spotlight if you'd like
I'll take you up.
All right, let's take you up.
Okay, great.
Wow, sister. I can't believe Mama made us move up north. This isn't a plantation, it's a farm. Whatsoever will we find to do here?
Oh, sister, really? Fiddledy-dee. I do declare. I'm going to tell you something. I have been sneaking around. Mama doesn't know. And I have found us some towns, and we're going to be fine.
Why, sister, I do declare that's exciting. Tell me more.
Well, just last night, I found a little town right here.
Le Sueur is located 50 miles south of the Twin Cities, or 25 miles north of Mankato. Located on the Minnesota River, Le Sueur has a rich history with an active historical society and several museums. The small town atmosphere provides safe, friendly neighborhoods, affordable housing, numerous recreational activities, as well as excellent schools and medical services. You'll find Le Sueur a great place to visit and an exceptional place to move your family or company.
And, sister, I want to tell you about their businesses, too.
I love that town. How about one more?
Oh, great.
Sure. Why not? Let's take another one.
My name is Johnny Happney, and I'm on the case, a big case, to find out about the downtowns in our story country. The boss wants answers to what's going on, so I walk the streets to find our downtowns that have become the greatest streets of Minnesota. The case is clear. Now I will take what I've learned to the big boss.
Oh, Johnny, show the big boss what you found. Ah, Johnny, this is another great downtown, a downtown rich with history and a hometown feel. Downtown Fairmont is a hotbed of activities and a treasure trove of fine shops, restaurants, and service businesses. Oh, Johnny, my boy, just look at their businesses. Johnny. Shops, services, and entertainment. Show me some more. Have discovered towns that have become part of our story. Now get back on the case.
It appears the talk is true. These are the towns dreams are made of. I will continue on the case, for I am Johnny. Johnny Happily. Our story, the streets of Minnesota.
I love it. Every town one of your citizens visit makes me want to go there.
Well, isn't that great?
I'll tell you, it's a wonderful thing. Mm-hmm. You know, and if you like those towns, I'm going to tell you right now, you are going to love Hid Away, Not Forgotten.
Yes.
Let's take a look.
Hello, Sweet Swine County. This is your roving reporter, Clarice. Today, we're hidden away in beautiful Martin County, Minnesota. I'm visiting the Four Columns Inn Bed and Breakfast, 6 miles south of Tremont. Overlooking what was once the Winnebago-Jackson Stagecoach Road, Four Columns Inn was originally built in 1884 by George Road. Built as a four-bedroom hunting and fishing retreat, it later served stagecoach travelers coming through the area. In 1938, Gilbert Kittleson purchased the land, and in 1948, his son Norman moved to the farm and married his wife Penny. Over the years, Norman and Penny converted the farmhouse into a Greek Revival bed and breakfast, which opened in 1991. The four 18-foot columns that grace the front of the inn and give it its name were constructed by Norman. The charming living room boasts a spiral staircase made by Norman, and a grand piano where Norman serenades guests each morning. Because of the couple's interests, the inn is filled with antiques and musical instruments. But one of the more unusual aspects of this home is the widow's walk at the top of the house. It provides wonderful views of the countryside around the inn. Guests from around the world have marked their home on the visitor map. From outside Sweet Swine County, this is Clarice. And as my Norwegian Nana would have said, hid away hardly means forgotten. Bye.
You're right. I love that.
Thank you, Jay, for
you
coming today.
Yes.
It was a delight having you.
You're certainly welcome.
Thank you to our citizens for their reports, mm-hmm. and to you, our viewers, for
Absolutely.
Watching the Cocklebur Morning Show, where we weed out the big stories throughout Sweet Swine County. Bye-bye for now.
Bye now.